In this country, you can be anything you want. There's nothing holding you back. If you work hard enough, you can get it. I didn't grow up, I'm 36 years old. I didn't grow up in this country ever in my life thinking, I can't do this, I can't do that because I'm black. I said, if I want to do it, let me just work hard and I can do it.
Refund the police. They say black lives matter, right? Refund the police!
Fuck you, you bastard ass! Fuck you!
Refund the police!
Fuck you!
You devil! They don't care! They don't care! They don't care! They don't care!
The root is communism. They want to just push out every single foundation America has had that has made us the strongest country in the world. And what they want to do is bring us down to our knees so desperate to where we racially can't get along. People are terrorizing us. There's no justice system. If we deny God and we deny righteousness and truth, we in trouble.
Some folks like to get away. Take a holiday from the neighborhood. Hop a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. But I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. Seen all the movie stars in their fancy cars and their limousines. Been high in the Rockies, under the evergreens. I know what I'm needing, and I don't want to waste more time. I'm in a New York state of mind.
There is one problem with being the silent majority in this country, the fact that we often have to keep quiet or otherwise silent about our views. For many conservatives out there, you may have lost friends or family just for supporting Trump. You might find that you can't even have a simple conversation with totally brainwashed liberals. I live in New York City, which as many of you know is primarily Democrat. There is hardly any room for political differences. Trump supporters are at risk of losing their jobs if they were to make their views public. And you're basically forced to either blend in with the liberal crowd or keep your damn mouth shut. Especially since the rioting and looting started, many conservatives are afraid to speak out against social justice warriors and their quote-unquote anti-racist agenda. In New York City, it's almost impossible to find other conservatives without specially planned meetings. And while it's perfectly okay for Chaz residents, looters, and rioters to violate social distancing rules, getting together for a Trump rally or anything that doesn't support Black Lives Matter is strictly forbidden. Our First Amendment rights are at stake, and it's about time we start fighting back. Bevelyn Beatty, Christian conservative and co-founder of At the Well Ministries, was arrested outside of Trump Tower for vandalizing the newly painted Black Lives Matter mural, or as I refer to it, graffiti.
They don't care! They don't care! They don't care about us!
Stop! This needs to stop!
If smearing black paint on a mural is considered vandalism, perhaps the various mayors and governors across the country can revise their statements about those riots being peaceful protests. In the past few months, we have no doubt felt the anger and frustration with everything going on, including the Black Lives Matter protests themselves, the defunding of police, spikes in violent crime across the country, and this fucking lockdown which is completely unconstitutional and is almost entirely politically driven. Perhaps there's a positive side of this Black Lives Matter graffiti for conservatives. It has turned out to be a fantastic opportunity for us to get our voices heard. No longer do conservatives in New York City have to stay in the closet. It's time for us to stop playing nice. About a week prior to this event, New York conservative Christopher Wright held the Turn NY Red rally, bringing patriots and conservatives alike to show support for President Trump and to protest the Black Lives Matter mural.
Listen about Black Lives Matter. Lives Matter. If you're really about Black Lives Matter, I'm about all Black Lives Matter. How about the black lives that have been murdered in the name of this group, in the name of George Floyd? They're killing blacks all over the country. Let me tell you guys some names right now. We got Italia Marie. She was shot and killed by a rioter. David Dorn, a 77-year-old former police officer, killed in front of his friend's small business, a black-owned business. We got Dave Patrick Underwood, federal officer, murdered by Black Lives Matter. We got David McCaddy, killed in the crossfire by Black Lives Matter. Chris Beatty, former real estate agent and college football player, murdered in the name of Black Lives Matter.
All lives matter.
Don't let the radical left brainwash you into believing the nonsense.
To make everything better, to make everything, we need to get rid of racism. And I'm not going to stop saying that, because racism is a problem. And the reason why it's a problem is because, again, it comes back to the skin tone. The reason why it comes back to the skin tone is I can't ride on the street and feel like I can sit down in my vehicle without being bothered by the police.
I was born and raised Democrat all my life. My parents are immigrants from the Dominican Republic. And I realized that I never questioned why I'm a Democrat. You're just trained to be a Democrat, especially if you're born black or Latino, but you can't question anything. I think that it's important that kids and young adults should be given the right to choose whether they want to be a Democrat or a Republican. And I feel like I should be able to support Republicans without receiving backlash, without being called a racist and a coon. We're in a free nation, and there's no problem if you want to be a Democrat. However, I should not be in fear of losing my job, in fear of receiving death threats, in fear of receiving negative comments because of my choice. That's the only thing that I have to say. I do not want to live in a country that is communistic or socialistic.
Your life matter until all black lives matter? So when black lives matter, then your life will matter.
I don't know. I'm not going to answer a stupid question.
You're not black. You're saying no lives matter until black lives matter. Does your own life matter?
Not until everybody does.
Okay. Yeah. You say that your own life doesn't matter. Think about that.
All these rappers and actors and this, that, they living behind that high mansion, right? But they trying to tell us, the average Joe, us, that we should hate the president because he's putting America's first. Are you kidding me? That's what we need. It's nothing against nobody. But if you don't protect your own first, how you going to try to protect the neighbor?
What's the most racist thing that you think you've heard Trump say?
How much time you got? Like, I have to leave, but everything he said is racist.
Can you name one thing?
Well, first off, saying that all Mexicans in this country are rapists and drug dealers.
Well, he actually was referring to illegal immigrants.
They want to say Trump's racist. All I know is, because of the president, I've been to the White House twice in 2 years, thanks to the Young Black Leadership Summit, and Charlie Kirk and all patriots out there. I got invited from President Trump to the White House, got to hear the man speak. Was a part of the largest gathering of black conservatives in American history. We had over 400 black conservatives at the White House. You should have saw those liberals' faces, seeing 400 black people walking down the street with MAGA hats on, talking about Trump 2020. They didn't know what to do with themselves. So this is a racist president. He's so racist, he brought lowest black unemployment in American history. How racist. He's so racist, he's the only first president to permanently give donations to HBCUs, black universities. How racist. It's the First Step Act. You know, the First Step Act getting rid of the three strikes law, imprisoned more blacks than ended in 8 years under Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton and Joe Biden introduced the law into Congress, and then imprisoned more blacks than any law ever passed in American history. First time I dealt with racism in this country is when I said I was conservative. That's when I saw racism. And I'll tell you where I saw it from. White liberals, low expectation racism. They're looking at me like, oh, what do you know? Oh, you're a black conservative. You don't know any better. Let me teach you. Let me raise you. That's how they act towards you. And when they said I stood up my own 2 feet without any help from any welfare system or government assistance, then they start discrediting me. Then they start saying, oh, Uncle Tom, you're a coon. You're all this. And I'm like, oh, you're a racist. And they look at me like, I'm not being racist. You just told a black man he's not being black enough. That's racist.
You know, we produce results. Liberals don't produce no results. I say, here's a black man, a straight black man, I'm challenging you, all right? What y'all doing, all the money y'all getting is not coming to us. It's not fighting for our cause. But here you are promoting Black Lives Matter and acting like black man talking we can't represent for ourselves. You know, I'm asking them, how do it matter to you when you're doing nothing to help us out? We're causing chaos in our urban community. They're just using our name, Black Lives Matter, to push their fake agenda. And I'm tired of it.
I didn't agree with the fact that DeBlasio told people that it's okay to, you know, go protest and that he wrote Black Lives Matter on the streets, because we have bigger issues that we need to deal with. I think, if anything, what DeBlasio and Cuomo should have said, what happened to George Floyd was a very horrible situation. But he should have never condoned or told people, that it's okay to go loot the same businesses that are owned by Black and Latinos. I think that's insane. I definitely support the police. I used to work in the shelter system where the police was called on a daily basis and they were always helping me. Yes, there are police officers that are corrupted, but overall, people need to think of the fact that every time a police officer leaves their house, that is a walking death sentence, okay? They're here basically supervising our neighborhoods, and we never take the time to thank the police officers. So I think that what he did was insane, and I definitely do not support that. Why? Because a lot of celebrities and politicians have armed security 24/7, yet the regular civilians now have to deal with the backlash of the police, which is insane. Because at the end of the day, just because of what happened with Minneapolis, New York Police Department had nothing to do with that, and that's not the way that you should handle the situation.
More than ever, we need events like this in New York to help conservative voices get heard. Even if you have nothing better to do, go to Trump Tower and shout All Lives Matter. I'm serious. We need to stop hiding and stop caring about what the left thinks.
New poll shows majority of Americans now oppose Black Lives Matter. That's right, numbers have flipped since early June. After enjoying a surge in support following the death of George Kirby, a new poll reveals that a majority of Americans now oppose the Black Lives Matter movement. The survey, conducted by Civics, showed that in early June, 44% of Americans supported BLM and 34% opposed it. However, those numbers have now changed, with 41% supporting BLM and 44% opposing the movement. And here's a picture of the poll. Look at that flip right there. That's pretty important. But look more importantly at the neither support nor oppose. It has plummeted.
Yes, we're out here celebrating Black Lives Matters. That's what we're doing. We're celebrating the fact that Trump brought the black unemployment rate to the lowest in American history. So we celebrate that, and the blacks are also celebrating the fact that so they emblazoned this in front of Trump Towers to say thank you. Thank you for giving us jobs, President Trump, because our lives matter.
De Blasio and Cuomo are destroying this city and bringing it back to the period of lawlessness before Giuliani came onto the scene.
There were 21 shootings with 37 victims. Four of them died. And in the Bronx, a bullet crashed through the windshield of a marked NYPD vehicle with two officers inside.
It's not just politics that are at stake here. The city of New York needs law and order.
One of the few times where everyone comes together knowing that we as professionals are under assault. Where the signs on the street are dictating the legislation that happens, but it's worse than that. We here in the city are doing this in the backdrop of a night where we had seven shootings in 4 minutes, eight shootings in 5 hours. Homicides went from 5 to 13. Burglaries have quadrupled. You may ask why. Why now? How is this happening? How is this happening when we have so many professional, caring law enforcement officers out there on the street? And the answer is simple. There's been a message not only from our city hall, but from the state house that says there will be a soft touch.
The Trump administration and many Republicans are the only ones speaking out against this insanity and attempting to come up with solutions. Democrats have done everything to make this situation worse because they want it to be this way. They only care about power. If you're a New Yorker, do the right thing in November and vote Republican all the way.
The Black Lives Matter movement is a terrorist organization in my mind. There has been violence, looting, crime. It's egregious and just very, very wrong. And I think it should be banned. I think we should think about banning it and putting these people in jail. They have used our parade to promote their agenda, to promote their narrative that conservatism is a bad thing, that it oppresses people, it oppresses gay people, it oppresses black people, it oppresses Hispanic people. Bullshit.
So, Derek, why are you running for governor?
Because I see our state has crumbled to seem like the point of no return, so I just had to throw my hat into the ring so I can bring equal justice back, so I can lower the taxes and give all our citizens a chance for the chance at the American dream, which they don't have at this moment in the city of New York. Me and Chris will go a long way back when it wasn't in style to be a Trump supporter up here. We was out and about with our big Trump flags all in Times Square. We was liberating the city. So that's what we did, and it's moving forward. And I urge everyone else to come out and show your support for President Trump.